Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Jessica, and today I'm going to be doing another week of the pantry challenge. It is a little bit cold outside. I'm just waiting for my buckets to fill up so I can finish watering everything. This week will be a little different. I was sick for a few days this week. And if you guys like my videos, go ahead and hit the thumbs up button. And please subscribe and hit the bell notification so you don't miss new videos. Let's get cooking. Alright, for our day one breakfast, I made some buttermilk pancakes that mix that I had on hand that all you do is add water. I did make some extra so that way that when the kids got home, they could have some for snack. And all we did was top it with some homemade apple butter from the basement. And George added a little bit of syrup to his. Now for lunch and dinner, I made a giant pot of chili. And all I did was dump some hamburger and mixture of beans. It was smaller than the last batch I made in the pantry challenge. And what I do is make that a couple times a month in the wintertime just because it is so easy. Now, with the chili, we added some corn muffins that I had a box laying around. And I just followed the instructions on the side of the box. And so I added the egg and the milk to it and whipped it all up. Muffins are done, and the chili looks like that's ready. Looks pretty good. I think we'll dish up some food. There it is. All right, for day two breakfast, I am taking a jar of my canned chunked pumpkin and a jar of my canned chunked squash, butternut squash. I drain them and then I'm putting them into my mixer to make a puree, just like that. And then I'm going to take some of this and I'm going to be making a couple recipes, but the first one is going to be some pumpkin oatmeal meal.
Okay. I am going to make some, I call it pumpkin pie oatmeal is what I call it to my kids. They really like it. It's from the book, Deceptively Delicious. Where you add a lot of vegetables to stuff and basically try and trick kids. Basically, that's what I mean. So, into my saucepan, I am going to add, I'm making a double batch. I am going to add half a cup of the pumpkin puree that, I guess it's a combination of butternut squash and pumpkin. Then to that, I'm going to add 2 cups of milk. Then to that, I'm going to add 1/2 cup of brown sugar. Like that. Okay, and then to that, I'm going to add about 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon, or you can do half a teaspoon of cinnamon or pumpkin spice, whatever you prefer, and 2 teaspoons of vanilla. Let me see. That's about 2 teaspoons. And then you're going to cook this until it comes to a boil. Let's see, gotta actually turn thing on and do some mixing. I'm going to add my 2 cups of oatmeal. It says to use old-fashioned oats, but I got cocoa oats, so that's what I'm using. And then we're supposed to cook it for about 2 to 3 minutes. All right, she's done. I'm going to serve that up. I'm going to start my next pumpkin-y thing. Okay, now I had to add a little bit more pumpkin and grind that up because I did not have enough for the cookies. I needed about, hold on, there we go. I needed about 1 can full. So that is about 1.5 cups or so, rough estimate of pumpkin. Now, I wanted to make pumpkin cookies that require 2 ingredients. Pumpkin, 1 can of pumpkin, and a spice cake mix. I do not have a spice cake mix. I have a yellow cake mix. So we are going to convert this into a spice cake mix, but I'm going to do it in here. Okay, I added my yellow cake mix. Now, to convert it into a spice cake mix, I am going to add 1 teaspoon of cinnamon. And I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of allspice, ground allspice. And 1/4 teaspoon of ground ginger. And now I have my spice cake mix. And then what I'm going to do is just mix it up, and then I'm going to make my cookies. Okay. Mine are a little bit more runnier than, because I used my home and I had to grind it up. I had to use a little bit of the water, so, but we'll see how they turn out. I've never made this recipe. Hopefully they turn out.
Well, that definitely did not work. Here is my wrapping paper, or my parchment paper after I buckle it off.
Definitely need to spray the next one, so I'm going to change it out and put for the next one. And there are the finished cookies. Nice and big and fluffy. Now for day 3 and 4, the kids ate leftovers and my mom brought them food because I was ill. This morning for breakfast, I made a giant blueberry muffin, which George ate some of the blueberries. I did like the Jessica on Three Rivers. She just puts it in a giant pie pan. So it was a little bit easier and should be pretty easy to wash out. So I'm just going to enjoy a sample. Oh, yeah. Oh, great. Okay. I have one of these brown and surf things that I had before Christmas that I got to get used up. So for lunch, we are going to be, what I did was I took them out. Cut them in half. I don't have any lunch meat or any ham cooked up that I could stick in between, so I'm just going to do cheese. Okay, I got all the cheese in there. Now I can melt some butter and put that on there, but I'm just going to try it using my cooking spray. We'll see how it works. May regret it, but I'm gonna spray the top of them. And then I'm going to take my everything bagel seasoning, and we're going to sprinkle them on top. And then I'm going to stick these in the oven. Yeah, we'll try. We'll start it. Does it say even on the package of the bread how to warm that up? So we'll stick it in the oven for 400 for about 8 to 10 minutes. Part I took a can of vegetable soup, just a store-bought can, a condensed can, and I stuck it in the microwavable bowl, added the can of water. Now I'm just going to microwave it until it's done.
All right, those are done, and the soup is just about done. So here's our lunch. Now for supper, we are having some pot roast. This is just one of the pot roasts that we had in the freezer from Mystery Raised. Now I did season it with salt and pepper. Then in the crock pot, I also added some water on the bottom so it doesn't scorch. On top of that, I added a chopped onion. And around the sides, I'm just stuffing in some potatoes that I scrubbed up and I quartered them because they were starting to get a little bit of eye. So I just cut those eyes out and then I just chopped it off. Now, I did not have any raw carrots, but I do have some cans of carrots downstairs that I had canned up. Kids aren't big fans of cooked carrots plain, but if they're cooked in the pot roast juices, they like them. So that's the way I can get them to eat them. Now for the snack, we do have a couple of these Rice Krispie tree kits that went on sale right after Christmas that I bought. So I'm going to make those up.
All right, we're going to add our butter.
Just halfway.
And then I got two of those packages, so I'm going to add both of them. I'm just going to make them both up.
We are making a double batch.
And I'm going to stick it in the microwave to melt my marshmallows. All right, I added the green dye, and then I'm going to stick it back in the microwave again. I'm only going to add one of the packets instead of both of them. All right, it's all melted and gooey. Now I'm going to add my Rice Krispies. Take the icing and cut off the tip. We are going to put the icing on yet. Alright guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this week's Bantu Challenge. I am in the process of working at cleaning out my refrigerators, or not my refrigerators, my freezers, and getting them organized and all my cans and all that so I can get a running list of what I want to finish doing or how I want to finish and use up for this Bantu Challenge. Alright, you guys have a good day and I will see you next week and God bless.